show that for the Sheffer stroke, which is represented by this vertical bar here, P and Q is logically equivalent to, and then it's P Sheffer stroke Q Sheffer stroke with P Sheffer stroke with Q. It sounds very weird to say out loud. Then use the results of example 2.4.7 and part A above to write P and then parentheses not Q or R using only Sheffer strokes. So what is the Sheffer stroke? The Sheffer stroke is logically equivalent to the negation of the output of the AND operation between P and Q. So it's P and Q, and then take the negation of that output. And that's your answer. That is the Sheffer stroke. This is also known as the NAND operation. It's the negation of the AND operation. So we have to use the definition of the Sheffer stroke to show that P and Q is logically equivalent to this Boolean expression using Sheffer strokes. So whenever I'm showing that two Boolean expressions are logically equivalent, and that logical equivalence will be shown by Boolean algebra, I like to start with the more complicated side, which is the right-hand side of this logical equivalence, and deconstruct each of these Sheffer strokes using this definition here. And then at the end, the goal is to get P and Q. Okay, so let's talk about how we're going to do this specifically. So this expression right here, this Boolean expression, is the negation of the AND operation, but it's also the Sheffer stroke. And so each time we see P Sheffer stroke Q, we can replace that expression with this Boolean expression. So let's first do this substitution, and we're going to do it twice because there's two instances of P Sheffer stroke Q. So I'm going to substitute both of these expressions with the negation of the AND operation. Now I'm going to leave this Sheffer stroke as a Sheffer stroke. I'm not going to deconstruct it yet. If you're capable of doing both of these steps at the same time, some people are, then I encourage you to try it. But I think it's best we deconstruct these two Sheffer strokes first, and then we'll deal with this middle Sheffer stroke later, just because the substitution is just going to be easier and more apparent from here. So the first substitution is going to be not P and Q, and I'm putting this entire substitution in parentheses. So there's an extra pair of parentheses right here because this whole Boolean expression is the input of this Sheffer stroke. And so next we're going to do the second substitution with the right Sheffer stroke and replace that with not P and Q. And I put this substitution in parentheses as well. We can think of the left-hand side of this Sheffer stroke as my P in this rule. I can think of the right-hand side of this Sheffer stroke as my Q. And so according to the definition of the Sheffer stroke, this Boolean expression is logically equivalent to the negation of P and Q. But what is P and Q? Well, P is this light blue Boolean expression, and Q is this purple Boolean expression. And so according to the definition of the Sheffer stroke, this is the negation of the AND operation. But this is where I put P, and this is where I put Q. Now, P and Q are the same thing. And so when I substitute in for P, whenever I do substitution, I put my substitution in parentheses. But I also don't need two pairs of parentheses around the same object. So I can put this as parentheses not, and then parentheses P and Q. And then we have this AND operation. And then the second thing we're substituting here is also not P and Q. Okay, so now we have a Boolean expression that has no Sheffer strokes. And so now we can apply the laws of logic to simplify this Boolean expression. I can start by distributing this negation symbol using De Morgan's laws. And this negation symbol would cancel out with both of these negation symbols, and we would flip the AND operation to an OR operation. So now we're left with P and Q or P and Q. Now, if you notice that the inputs of this OR operation are the same. So then by the idempotent laws, this is logically equivalent to just P and Q. And if you remember back in the beginning of this video, I mentioned that this is exactly what we were trying to show. So let's just briefly review what we just did. We started with the right-hand side of this logical equivalence, and we deconstructed that into more basic building blocks of Boolean algebra without using any Sheffer strokes. And then we simplified that Boolean expression using the laws of logic to eventually simplify the entire statement to P and Q, which is the left-hand side of this logical equivalence. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can do part B, which says use the results of example 2.4.7 and part A above to write P and not Q or R using only Sheffer strokes. So let's do that next. Okay, so here I have the results from part A. We can use this fact, and we can use the results from example 2.4.7, which says that not P is logically equivalent to P Sheffer stroke with P, and that P or Q is logically equivalent to P Sheffer stroke P, Sheffer stroke with Q Sheffer stroke Q. So we can use all of these rules that we have shown so far to rewrite this long expression using only Sheffer strokes, which again, the Sheffer stroke is the NAND operation. So we can start with not Q here. According to example 2.4.7, we can replace not Q with Q Sheffer stroke Q. So our expression P and not Q or R is logically equivalent to P and Q Sheffer stroke Q. And since I'm doing a substitution, I'm going to put that substitution in parentheses. And then we have or R. So next I can work with this or operation, or I can work with this and operation. Both simplifications are going to be pretty messy. Since we should usually work with parentheses first, I'm going to rewrite this or operation using example 2.4.7. But in this case, the letters get a little confusing. So Q Sheffer stroke Q is going to be my P and R is going to be my Q. And so now I have to do this substitution, but instead of using P's and Q's, I have to use Q Sheffer stroke Q and R respectively. So this is logically equivalent to P and now I have to use this rule as my framework. It's P Sheffer stroke P, but in this case, my P is Q Sheffer stroke Q. So that would be Q Sheffer stroke Q for each of these P's, which is Q Sheffer stroke Q. That's one P, and then that's Sheffer stroke with the same P, which is Q Sheffer stroke Q. Okay, so far we have done the P Sheffer stroke P part of this expression. Now we have to put this in parentheses and Sheffer stroke that with Q Sheffer stroke Q. But in this case, my Q is R. So that's going to be R Sheffer stroke R. And then I can end my last parentheses there. So my end result would be P Sheffer stroke with Q. But Q, remember, is this long expression, which is going to need three opening parentheses, and then Q Sheffer stroke Q, end parentheses, Sheffer stroke with Q Sheffer stroke Q, end parentheses, and then we end that set of parentheses, Sheffer stroked with R Sheffer stroke R, end parentheses. I just got to lengthen this a little bit. So this highlighted part is the Q in the formula from part A of this problem. So I'm just going to copy this, and I'll paste that later when I get to my second Q in this formula. So now I can close this parentheses, and then Sheffer stroke, and then open parentheses, and then P. But then Q, again, is this long Boolean expression. But I copied it earlier, so I can just paste it here, and then close my parentheses. And that's how we write P and not Q or R using only Sheffer strokes. Is this long expression involving 13 Sheffer strokes and 24 parentheses. But the important part of this problem is that we can convert our most basic logical operations into just Sheffer strokes. That's pretty significant. Thanks everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.